So now let's just write down our function here again for x of t. So we've got our index k here, ck e to j 2 pi k f1 t. So now the question is, so how can we calculate these key, these cks here? So how to calculate ck? And this is done by this formula here, ck equals to 1 over tp. So that's the time of one period of this signal, integrated over tp x of t e to minus j 2 pi f1 t dt. So we see there's not much difference between these two formulas here. It's basically just this sign has changed here from positive to negative. So this tp here is one period. So if you think again of our heartbeat here, so that's our heartbeat, then this tp, this is here our tp, so for one period here. So we're integrating over this, and then so this we are getting our cks here. So what are these properties of ck? So is there anything we can say about the ck? And that's a very interesting or very important relation. So if x of t is real, so if it really is real valued, then ck equals c minus k star, and star means here the complex conjugate. Complex conjugate just means inverting the imaginary part. Or we can also write this in our phasor description, so that we have ck equals ck, and we use the amplitude of that, or the radius, and we define a phase angle with that, phi k, so something like this. So that's a radius, or the absolute value, and this is our phase, and then our c minus k has the same amplitude, but we're just rotating the other way around. So j minus j phi k. So we just go the other way around. And so we've got this relationship here.